A really big cinematic trailer just dropped for Battlefield 2042, and it released some very interesting information. It was a very good trailer in my opinion, I liked it a lot, and it's going to set up the scene for how the world falls into a global war within Battlefield 2042. You've got the Americans, the Russians, and the NOPATs that kind of sit in the middle. They're from all the failed states around the world. Now, some details that you need to know right off the bat here. Irish is returning from Battlefield 4's Tombstone Squad as a playable specialist in Battlefield 2042, and he takes a lead role in this cinematic trailer. Now, Pack, another of the Tombstone Squad, he also appears in the trailer, but we don't have any extra information on him at the moment. We can now say, though, that in some way, the Battlefield 4 universe and the 2042 universe, they are linked together, because we've got a character from Battlefield 4 here in 2042. Or maybe there's some kind of like Battlefield universe story out there that DICE is working on that is going to link together all the events and all the different actions from previous Battlefield titles and then bring them together here for the first time. That would be really, really cool. And an extra bit of info here, based on a video from Jack Frags, it seems that the original voice and motion capture actor of Irish in Battlefield 4, Michael K. Williams, he is back here in 2042 providing the same stuff. So not only have we got a progression of the character in the game, but we've also got a progression of the real life actor as well, which is awesome. Irish is going to be a playable character, as I mentioned, in Battlefield 2042. He is one of the many specialists that will be coming to the game at launch, and I've got some information here that I can share with you on what gameplay style he will be taking on in multiplayer. So Irish is an engineer class specialist, his specialty gadget is a fortification system, and his trait is called Veteran. Now, the fortification system is actually two different gadgets that can be deployed, I think, at the same time. The first of them is called the DCS Deployable Cover. It can be placed on any flat surface, and it creates a small protective barrier, allowing allies to see through a bulletproof glass window in it. Now, the barrier does have a finite amount of health, so it will be protecting you for as long as it can, but it is obviously susceptible to incoming fire and explosions, so it's not going to last forever. But you can place multiple of these around the map at once, and I'm guessing you can't just place one, and then two, and then three, and then four really quickly. There will probably be a cooldown timer on there, so you can't spam them. But maybe you need to put one up in one location, and then the battle moves somewhere else, and a few minutes later you need to place another. It sounds like you can place a second one, and then the first one won't disappear, which is kind of interesting. And it also means that you've got some pretty cool gameplay examples that this could really work in. You might want to peek a corner, so you put the barrier down on the edge of the corner, and then you can sort of use it to look round the corner through the bulletproof glass or something like that. Or maybe somebody out in the open needs to be revived, you could run over and put the barrier down in front of them and then revive them behind the barrier and save a teammate from dying. Sounds pretty interesting. And then the second of the two gadgets is called the APS-36 Shootdown Sentinel. And I think most people know what an APS is, but when it's placed on any flat surface, it's going to eliminate incoming explosive projectiles. So if somebody throws a grenade into a room and you've put one down on the floor, rather than it exploding, it will just destroy it and you won't be harmed from that explosion. Now, the trait is called Veteran, and this allows Irish to, quote, dig in and stay alive. He will always spawn with a small amount of body armor that can be replenished whenever he collects dropped ammo packs from defeated foes. Now, the mention of armor here has got me a little bit nervous. Likely a lot of players will want to pick this specialist because he has more health compared to others, but I'm going to reserve my judgment until I actually get a chance to play the game. There's so many different variables in a game like Battlefield anyway, plus we've now got 128 players instead of 64, so what's that, double the amount of variables on top of all the variables you already had? So yeah, there's a lot to think about, but maybe there's a way of negating those armor plates. We do know that Battlefield 2042 has different ammo types, so you might be able to choose an armor-piercing round for your gun, and then that negates those armor plates or something like that. It's too soon to tell. We don't know what's happening there, but, you know, there will always be a counter to these things, so we just need to figure out what that is. Now, there is a huge amount of detail to unpack from this Exodus trailer, but I haven't really had a chance to sit through it and watch it and pick out all the different details yet, because it's so in-depth and it's about 9 minutes long. So I'm going to hold off on that video until tomorrow, and I'll post something that picks out as much as I can find, and maybe if there are other people that have found stuff and posted it on social media and Reddit, I can include those finds as well. And we're just going to try to sort of get a grasp of what we're going to be dealing with in Battlefield 2042. But if you haven't watched the cinematic trailer, then I highly recommend you do go and watch it. It is very, very cool. Thanks very much for watching. Leave a like if you enjoyed this one, and subscribe for more Battlefield 2042 content coming in the future. And I'll catch you all in the next one.